So for the first part of the build video, we're gonna make the fuselage of the airplane. In this case, I've just taken a barbecue stick. This one measures about 24 centimeters, but definitely this is not gonna be long enough. And so I've taken another small piece. This is an additional 10 centimeter piece. And we're gonna stick this to the other and make it a larger fuselage. To ensure that we have a strong joint, we can take our X-Acto knife and take out the top half of one of the pieces and do the same with the other piece. And that's how we can join the two pieces together in a very efficient way. I've decided to use super glue to stick the two pieces together. You could use hot glue, but I just find super glue to be a bit more effective. Now you just want to let this dry, don't want to rush it. And while that is drying, we can move on to the propeller. Now out of all the materials that I've used to make a propeller before, I still find a pop bottle can to be the most effective. You would really make a good propeller out of this material. Now to make the propeller blades, I'm just gonna do it with manual inspection. I have no particular design. I'm just gonna eyeball it and make a rough, circular, large propeller. So I've just used my scissors to really nicely carve out this propeller, and it turned out to be a bit smaller. I wanted it to be a bit larger, a bit wider, but that's okay. We'll just go with it. And so I'm gonna use this other piece, and using this piece, I'm gonna try to replicate it. It's not gonna be exactly the same, but we'll try our best. Now these are gonna be my propeller blades, and I'm gonna stick those on a piece of barbecue stick. So I'm gonna take about, let's say, 10 centimeters, and I'm gonna attach these two blades on the barbecue sticks. Previously on my other videos, I've also used like popsicle sticks to do that. But now let's see with barbecue sticks. I think it's just gonna be a bit more lighter, and I hope it's gonna be more efficient. Now this barbecue stick itself is pretty light, but we can definitely take it a step further and make it even more lighter. So I'm just gonna grab my X-Acto knife, and we can actually chop this barbecue stick in half, and it's actually quite easier than it looks. The step is quite easy. You just want to take your plier and just slightly bend the tip of it. This will allow you to get a little crack, and you can use your X-Acto knife and kind of pass it through halfway. So just want to poke it in the midsection. Just be very careful that you don't cut yourself. Just like that. They're two nice and even pieces. And so we're gonna use this piece and stick these two blades together. So I'm just gonna measure the midsection so I know where to attach my aluminum wire for both sides. And I'm going to measure half a centimeter away from the midsection. So about 4.5 this way, 5.5 the other way. This is gonna give me a reference as to where these two blades should sit. And if you have never made a propeller before, a propeller is never gonna be flat straight. We want our propellers to have a bit of a twist like that. And when you have that twist, that's gonna allow the propeller to push back the air. If it is completely flat, it's never gonna work mechanically. Now while the hot glue is heating up, I'm gonna proceed on to making the bearing or the propeller assembly. And for that, I'm gonna use a large aluminum steel wire, and you just wanna unbend it. This is already too large, we don't need too much of it. We're just gonna cut out some portion. Now this is a very critical step. We want our aluminum wire to be nice and straight as you can be. because when the propeller is revolving, we don't want any sort of vibration. And if you see, when this is revolving, it's having a lot of vibration. Now that sucks. That's gonna have a lot of waste energy. We want this piece to be very, very straight. So take your time, use your supplier, and be very sure that you make it as straight as you can. Now this is the fuselage, and we want to make a little bearing, some sort of thing that's gonna help the propeller spin. And the easiest way I found out is that just take a couple of pieces of barbecue sticks, and perhaps if we kind of like measure like, let's say 2 centimeters, take a couple of pieces of 2 centimeters, like 2 pieces of 2 centimeters, and we're gonna use our supplier and we're gonna chop them off. Now all we're gonna do is we're just gonna stick these 2 pieces and we're gonna stick that to the fuselage. So we're gonna stick these 2 pieces, we're gonna stick it to the fuselage, and it's gonna stick like that. And right here, what we're gonna stick is a plastic tubing. Now this is a plastic tube that I got from this very pen. What I did was I just opened it up and I just cut this off. And I didn't want to cut it further because as you can see, ink is gonna spill out and this area is gonna get super messy. So yeah, that's where I got it from. We're gonna use this as our propeller assembly. I'm just using the nozzle, which is a really, really hot surface, and I'm just using just a bit of hot glue, just a bit generous, and I'm gonna use this nozzle to kind of spread the glue evenly. And once again, just letting you know, we want our model to be very, very light, so avoid using hot glue anywhere, wherever it's not necessary. To me, that's pretty nice and strong, and I don't think any more hot glue is necessary, and I'll just leave that aside, and we'll focus onto the propeller. So these blades are gonna stick right there. I have these reference marks, and so I'll know where these propellers need to sit. So here I have the aluminum wire, and I'm gonna make a 90 degree bend. Now this is gonna sit right on the flat part of the barbecue stick, like that. I'm gonna use a very thin bead of glue for now. You don't wanna overload it. And we'll let this aluminum wire sit right on there. And before you wanna move further, you just wanna give it some time to dry. And because I've made a mess right there, you just wanna fix that. So I'm just gonna use just a bit, and I'm just gonna use the nozzle to kind of spread the glue evenly. And that's about it. You don't need to do anything more. To make sure that our propeller spins very smoothly, we're gonna choose a couple of beads. Now, these come out in very different sizes, and from my personal experience, like the small ones tend to work nice. So I'm gonna use 2 of them for now. Like these are just small enough, but the holes are large enough for the aluminum wire to pass through. So from my personal experience, the smaller, the better. So I'm just gonna use some hot glue around this root. And that's where this bead, this plastic bead, is gonna sit through. It's gonna be right there. I see there's a lot of excess glue. I'll just use my finger to kind of remove it. I don't need it, so. Let that sit there really nice and strong. And if there's a little gap, you can always use just a bit of hot glue to kind of shape it. And that looks to me a pretty nice and solid assembly. Let's move on to attaching these blades onto this barbecue stick. So I'll just use a very thin bit of glue. And I'm gonna stick this onto the barbecue stick and make sure that it's not flat. We need it to have a little bit of a twist. So what I mean by that, when you stick it on, put it nice and 90 degree and have a little bit of bend, like that. We don't want it to be straight, a little bit of bend. So because of this bend, whenever you're holding it straight, you'll see that there's a little bit of a curve, and that curve is gonna help you catch the air. We'll do the same with the other side. So we'll put some thin bit of glue and we'll attach it to the other side of the barbecue stick. And this time we also want to have that bend. So just like that. Try to be precise and have the right sort of bend on both the sides so that both the blades are having the right amount of bend. And previously what I used to do, I used to use my hot glue and just use it all around the edges. And to my surprise, it had no effect on the propeller assembly. What it did to the propeller was just make it a lot heavier, and that sucks. This is a propeller that needs to be very light because this is going to revolve all around the flight, and we don't want this to be a heavy product. And you don't need any more hot glue. That should be it. So as you can see, our propeller is all ready. To make sure that the propeller is made properly, you can spin it and you should find air thrusting backwards. And that to me looks pretty good. This is our propeller assembly of the fuselage. And now we're gonna attach the other bead. Where is it? I'll just take another one. Oh yeah, there it is. So this bead is gonna sit right on top of the tubing, like that. And you'll need to hot glue it right there. The best way to do it is to pass it through this propeller, through the tubing. And while you're holding it from the other side, you want to attach the hot glue onto this part of the bead. So we'll hold it nice and tight and apply a very thin bit of glue, just enough for it to hold it in place. Now let's make the hook. So it's a pretty easy process. You want to take your plier and you want to bend it like so. You can make it any way. I just like to make it look like a square. I think it helps rubber, it helps to catch the rubber band a bit nicer, better. There are several ways you can do it, and it really depends on how you like it. Chop off the excess. Well, it turned out to be a bit ugly, but should be okay. There you go. That seems to be fine. Now, the rubber band, which I'm gonna choose, is gonna be this one. It's a pretty nice and thick rubber band, elastic rubber band. You can take multiple smaller rubber bands, stick them all together, but I just wanna use this long rubber band. It's nice and efficient. I'm gonna hook it onto this piece, this aluminum wire. And this rubber band needs to hook to the other end of the fuselage, so I'm gonna take another aluminum wire, unbend it, and we're gonna stick it right at the end. There you go. The hook is attached and the propeller is ready. Let's give it a little test. We will now keep the fuselage aside and move on to making the wings and the other parts. So here we've got styrofoam plates. The reason I like this is because they're pretty light, very, very light. They're also pretty durable, so whenever your plane crashes, you're not gonna have a significant damage. So you're gonna need about 3 or 4 of them, depending on how large they are. So I'll take 2 at a time and I'll use my X-Acto knife and get out the rim. So the idea is that we're gonna have one middle wing, and from that middle wing, we're gonna have 2 other layers sticking out. So I'll just cut one more. Actually, I'll just take 2 more again and also cut those out. Now, as I've said before, this project is pretty much manual inspection. There's no planning, there's no measurement, and I'm just gonna make it out of the go. So just gonna try to make it a largest wing as possible. So I'll just take my ruler and I'll measure, let's say, 8 centimeters. You could go even greater. So like the longer width you're taking, the smaller length you're having. So with respect to that, I'll just choose 8. So this piece right here is about 8 centimeters by 13.5 centimeters. So depending on the size of your styrofoam, you're gonna have different shapes. And once you measure it once, you don't need to do this tedious step again and again. So you can just use this block as a reference to make the other pieces. So we now have 3 identical pieces for the wing, and what we're gonna do is that stick the 2 flaps to the center in an angle, and that's known as the dihedral. We're gonna have that and it should be a pretty nice fit, but we also want to add an airfoil shape to the wing. And the airfoil shape is basically a little curve that you have, so I'll just use my fingers and just make a rough idea for you. If we have that kind of curve for the wing, that's gonna help us generate more lift. And we want to do that. So you just wanna use your fingers and just curl the styrofoam piece. And because it's styrofoam plate, it's not gonna be too bad. Just like that, that should be good. We'll do this for the other 2. Now we've established a really nice curve for these pieces. And now in order for us to stick it to the middle, we need to put a little, we have some waste right there. It's not gonna have a really nice fitting. And for this, we're actually gonna curve cut it. And you're gonna see how that works. So the idea is, I'm just gonna cut out just like that. Just like that. And if we establish this cut, you should now realize that it gets significantly easier for us to stick these 2 pieces. We'll do the same with the other piece as well. There you go. Just have a little bit of object in front of you so that it helps you with the dihedral. You don't want more than, let's say, 35 degrees. That should be good. So once again, we want to use very, very less. We don't need to overload it with hot glue. We'll use just enough to cover the surface. Very gently, you want to stick these 2 pieces. Don't worry about the excess lobs of glue sticking in. Just place it like that and place the other object right in front of you so you have a bit of reference. You want to keep this for 20 to 30 seconds because we want this glue to dry up completely. Once that is dry, you can see that it's a really nice fitting. You don't need to add additional glue. This should be good. We'll do the same with the other one. Now, there are a lot of hot glues out there, such as the 200 watts or the 300 watts or the really, really hot ones. Now, you don't want to glue your hot glue and don't keep it in the heat for a long time. The problem with that is that when you have really, really hot glue and when you put it on the layer, the styrofoam starts to melt and that sucks. So just heat your hot glue just about it and don't need to heat it much. And just like that, we have made a really beautiful wing. It's already pretty strong. And just like that, we're gonna move on to making the fin and the rudder. And so I'll just make, let's say, 7. And I'll just eyeball it. So the tail is 7 centimeters wide and it's gonna be 13 centimeters long. And while I'm at it, I'll just measure the midsection as well. Now I'm making the rudder, and the height for the rudder is gonna be pretty nice and long, the vertical stabilizer, so I'll say 8 centimeters. This vertical stabilizer needs to be nice and straight. So make sure that you have a really nice perpendicular rudder. So lay it flat and you can just use manual inspection to ensure that it's nice and straight. So at this point, we've finished building the wing as well as the horizontal and vertical stabilizer. Now we're gonna put a little piece so that the wing can sit on it and you have a bit of a height. So let's do that. I've decided to double up this piece because it's going to support the entire wing, and so a single layer would be a bit too weak, so I'll just use 2 identical pieces. And once again, you don't need a crazy amount of hot glue, just a little dab here and there should be good. So I'm just using my ruler to measure the center so that I know where that piece can sit. So it's right about there. Now the reason I've cut it in a curly way is so that I can easily make this a really nice fitting. You want to use your middle finger and your thumb to hold it in place and you want to let it dry. And from the back, you want to make sure that it's nice and perpendicular to the surface of the wing. Now, the further you put your wing towards the fuselage, the more height you'll get, and the more behind you put, the more drag. And so you might need to adjust later by putting some weight in front, but I guess I'll just put it somewhere there. I think I'll go with the tail first, so I'll just stick the tail to it. And it doesn't need to entirely cover the surface of the horizontal stabilizer, just make sure it sits nice and straight. So, our plane is officially complete. Now for us to measure the center of gravity, just take two of your fingers and place it 33% away from the front edge, so somewhere around there. So if you place two of your fingers like so, and that's how you'll know how your plane balances. So, wow, it seems like the plane is really tail heavy, so it's probably gonna rise, but we'll still give it a shot. So, as you can see that the plane got significant amount of lift. We'll have another try and then we'll do some adjusting. So I just found this plastic. It's a pretty funny looking plastic. You can take anything similar like a coin or anything of that sort. So I'll just glue that on and let's see how that performs. I'll glue it to the nose on that bearing. That should be good. The plane seems to be balanced, but the problem is it's drifting too much to the right. We'll have one more shot and let's see what we can do. Whenever you have a bent propeller, you can just simply use your finger to kind of unbend it and make it straight. So the plane is drifting too much to the right. We can add a bit of a rudder and adjust that. All you have to do for that is that just cut a little piece of styrofoam. It doesn't have to be the right size of the vertical stabilizer. That should be good enough. And I found tape to be pretty useful. I'll just take a layer, put it in there. Now since the plane was drifting too much to the right, I'll place the rudder so that it faces the left. And we just need a little piece again, so just secures in place. You don't need to have too much of a sharp curve, just a bit should be enough. There you go, nice and sharp. All right, so we've fixed the pitch, we have fixed the direction. Now let's see how all that plays together. Anytime you feel that the rudder is way too sharp, you can always take your scissor and just cut out a little strip, and that's going to decrease the surface area, and now you're going to have a better outcome.